What's up, dude? This is the MX Simulator Beginner Guide, and I know some of you guys were requesting that I actually make this video because you were coming from Reflex or some other arcade motocross game and you're absolutely lost and you want a little bit of guidance in that beginner stage. And I know that's probably the most difficult part to it because you just don't know anything about the game. You don't know how important certain aspects are to have set up properly and all this other kind of stuff, because really an arcade motocross game is pretty hella simple in comparison to MX Simulator as far as like the get-go setup. You know, like with an arcade motocross game, you pretty much just hop on there and start playing. But with MX Simulator, there's actually a lot of steps and sort of things you gotta get figured out before you ever even get on the bike. And I think a lot of people may not understand that. But first of all, your controller. If you're on a keyboard, you're probably gonna straight up cry eventually, dude. So you've got to have a controller. But not only have a controller, you've got to figure out your button layout. And this is all stuff that basically needs to be done before you ever even get on the bike. And I started on keyboards, which was a pretty crazy experience, and it was awesome when I actually got a controller because I was ignorant and didn't realize, hey, you can just use a controller with this game. That's how basic and beginner I was with whenever I first got into MX Simulator. So get your controller. Preferably, I use the 360. I know a lot of people that use PS3, whatever, Xbox One. I mean, there's all different kinds of controllers you can try to use out there, but that becomes like a personal preference kind of thing. But you're trying to set it up for the best possible actual controls on the bike. That's what you've got to figure out, and that is also a very personal thing in this game because I think everybody in this game has somewhat of a different controller setup. I mean, something is a little bit different, and it's very important to get your comfort down with your controller. And you know, if you're coming from Reflex or something like that, try to actually set up your controller similar to Reflex controls. I think some people totally neglect that aspect because they're just kind of like, eh, you know, let's set this up like a Untamed or something like that. But if you're really used to how Reflex controls are, set your fucking controller up like Reflex, you know? You're trying to get it as close to whatever you're most used to, whether you know your different brakes and your clutches on the bumpers, and you got to figure all that stuff out and get it really down pat before you ever even really start playing MX Simulator. Because once you get your controls down, then you can just start building your mind muscle memory from there. You don't really have to worry about it. Holy shit, that flip! And it's very important. Oh my God, like, getting your controller set up down and just running the same thing over and over and over and over for a long period of time, that's what makes you good in MX Simulator. So that's super important. Get all of that stuff figured out. Make sure you have somewhat of a newer controller. Make sure it's not some worn out piece of ass that's been just rode hard and put up wet. Okay, so moving on to some of the more setup ishy type things that I would go in there and change. Setup ishy, that's a word from your homeboy. So you want to, I would go in there and change your stability to about, I would put it on 80 when you first start. You obviously could put it on 100, but that's just gonna make it even more harder to turn. I think 80's decent, and then you're gonna slowly work your way down from 80, and that's what's actually gonna hold the bike up for you. Because when you first get into the game, it's the bike's just gonna fall down in every single corner, and you're gonna think, "What the hell is this?" So, I would start on 80, and then depending on how much you play, I mean, it's gonna take a long time. I remember when I first started, like, it actually took me a long time to get to a low stability. I was thinking, how the heck are people riding with stabilities that low? I thought it was actually impossible, and that was that arcadey mindset. I didn't realize how much time people actually put into this game. So, you know, it's gonna take a long time before you get that stability worked all the way down, but you gotta not be scared to lower your stability, but don't lower it too quick, or then you can never learn. You see what I'm saying? So My neighbor's outside on his two-stroke right now. God dang, can a man not make a video, bro? It is a motocross video, so hey guys, you want to hear some two-strokes in the background? What's up? Oh my god. It's like, he's my mechanic as well, and he lives across the street, and he's always starting bikes up and stuff like that. So yeah, I do apologize for those background noises, but at least it's a dirt bike. So you know, if anything else. But okay, so you want to get your stability right, and that's a very important thing. And you also, you want to go in there and figure out how strong your brakes are. That is another very important thing. Because if you don't have strong enough brakes, you're not going to be able to stop, especially on a supercross track. So you want to go in there and kind of play around with how high you've got your braking torque on the front and the back, and actual, like, depending on what buttons you have it on, if you want it on anti-lock, if you want it on, or anti-lock, however the fuck you say that, tomato, tomato, English, bro. But however you want to do that, that's all personal preference. You've just got to figure it out for yourself. Nobody can really tell you what you need. It's one of those things, you've kind of just got to go in there and figure it out, man. You know, you got to go in there and test it out. And another thing is figuring out, do you want to ride in first person or third person? I personally recommend first person because it's a simulator, and that's kind of what the whole premise of the game is. But you know, and then you got to figure out your first person height and angle and all that kind of stuff. And you're just trying to figure out something that looks normal to your mind. And just because a first person camera looks good to this dude over here doesn't mean it's going to look good to Joe Blow over here. So it's, you know, it's just all different for everybody, I think. And that applies to basically everything in MX Simulator. So it's hard to tell somebody like exactly what to do, because it's just so many different personal preferences and stuff like that. And it makes a big difference, because comfort in this game, oh dude, it's so important. I mean, it's just crazy. But I'm trying to think of some other things right off the top of my head. Arcade physics, turn that shit off instantly as soon as you get in this game. Pronto ASAP. Do not ride with arcade physics at all, please. It's pointless. It's not helping you in any way. If anything, it's just hurting you, basically. It's not even really a crutch. It's just like a, I don't even know why the hell it's in this game, to be honest with you, but it's in there, and I think it's on default when you first get into the game. So be sure and turn that off, or at least it used to be anyways. But be sure and turn that off. I would go ahead and turn off those little red fucking things on the side that like indicate when you need a turn and stuff. Like, this is not Forza, bro, this is MX Simulator. Because those kind of crutches, those are things that it's just gonna get in your way in the long run. So it's better to start off without it, so that it's not even a crutch at all at that point, because you don't even remember ever having it like that. So yeah, you're trying to get all of your arcade mode off. You want to go in there and make sure your sit and dab and all that stuff is correct, because you can actually make a setting in this game where if you stop on the bike, your rider just falls over. Like, he doesn't actually sit down whenever you stop. So you want to make sure and have that where it does that, where whenever you come to a complete stop, you just sit down on the bike and you don't actually have to hit the button to sit down. You know what I'm saying? And then there's another like personal preference thing in there where you can make it to where your sit button is going to be sticky, which means, you know, you hit the button and then you got to hit it again to come off, or not sticky where you got to like basically hold the button down. So it's that's kind of another little thing like that. But let me get into the sort of tracks you should start with MX Simulator. So I think this is a big question. And number one, do not start with the stock tracks. Don't do it, bro. I do not recommend that at all. I mean, I think that's what most people think they should start on in this game. And personally, I just wouldn't, because A, they're so old. All of them are so old that the tractions and stuff like that are so different from the modern MX Simulator era. And trust me, I mean, I absolutely adore the stock tracks, and I think they're a critical part to the history of MX Simulator, and it's got a cool little vibe like that to them. But as far as, like, if you're just now starting MX Simulator, I would not start on stock tracks. Just because they're stock tracks doesn't even really necessarily mean that they're easier. It's just that they have hardly any roughness, small jumps, and a bizarre as hell actual traction on the track. That's pretty much all they are. And it's really, to me, I think it's way better to start on a 2011, 12, or 13 AMA Supercross track in this game. I would start on a 2013. If that's a little too difficult for you at the beginning, you can always start on a 2011 or a 12, but just always keep in mind, the further you go back in years of tracks in this game, the weirder the traction's going to be, the smaller the jumps are going to be, in a sense. So it's, you know, the quicker you can get to the newer tracks, the better. But I understand you have to work your way up in some sense. You can't just hop on a 2016 track and expect to blow people out of the water on it. It's just not going to work. So I would start on the Supercross tracks because A, you're not going to have to deal with any roughness, and B, you're going to be jumping basically constantly. So you're really going to learn how to lean on the bike and how to move on the bike. And you know, you don't really have time to rest on a Supercross track, so it really teaches you, like, how to get on the throttle in the corners and really hit a triple in out of a corner. You know, that's a pretty big stage when you can go from, like, just doubling in out of the corner to actually hitting a triple out of a corner. Not a main triple, but a, you know, a rhythm section triple. I remember that was, like, something really hard to do at the beginning of MX Simulator, but once you get that down, then it's like, oh, okay, this is sick now. And just remember, it's going to be very difficult at the beginning. I mean, I remember it being like, I played this game for a week straight, basically constantly falling down everywhere, in every corner, every whoop section. It took me at least a week or two or three. Hell, I don't even remember. It took me a long time before I could even just get around a track just doubling everything, you know? And then you start tripling everything, and then you start really picking up the speed in the corners, and then you start quadding something, and then hey, okay, I'm getting pretty good at these 2013 tracks. Let me go move up to the 14 tracks. And then you get really good at those, and you move up to the 15 tracks. And then you can kind of go through it like that, but you can always go hang out on a motocross track. Don't get me wrong. I mean, you need to do that eventually, but that's not what I would start on. I would start on these supercross tracks because it just seems to lend itself so much better to a beginner to me. And it's like probably the quickest way to actually learn the game, in my opinion. Quickest and easiest way. So another really big tip is, the quickest way to get better in this game is to race other people. That's going to push you more. It's going to open up your eyes to higher limits that you didn't even realize was possible in this game. A lot of different stuff like that. It's going to build consistency. It's going to build a little fire inside of you to actually get better when you get smoked a couple times, and when you start actually riding with people somewhat on your lower skill level, at like a beginner or an amateur level. It's fun to race with people like that because then you can actually, you know, have good little battles and stuff. And so you'll want to go in there in like 03 or some of those, you know, random servers and stuff like that, and just race, dude. Race and play the game as much as you possibly can. And that's really the only way to actually get better at MX Simulator. And first starting off in this game, when it comes to your actual suspension and everything, I would start with complete stock. I know some people totally disagree with me on that, but I would start with complete stock, and until you're actually, like, somewhat mobbing around the tracks, I would not change your suspension at all. I think some people don't realize how much time you put in just to get to the point to where you can even get around a Supercross track properly. And if you can't even do that, then what the hell is the point of upgrading your suspension? You know, I promise you can do it with stock suspension. I've made bukoodles of videos on that. But you can get around a 2017 SX track with complete stock suspension. I can hit every rhythm, everything with stock suspension. So that is not an excuse in saying, oh, you can't do it because it's stock suspension. Fuck no, dude. Do not listen to those idiots. You need to ride with stock suspension because it's not hurting you in any kind of way. And it may not necessarily be helping you in any kind of way, but I can promise you it's not hurting you. Whereas if you go in there and start jacking around with stuff, it could be hurting you in a certain way and you don't even realize it. So another thing you want to go in there and kind of look at is going to be your rider mass distribution. That's going to be stock, like all the way low, I think, or something like that. And that's really good for a beginner. And the better you get, you know, you can start messing around with that. All your different forward springs and vertical springs, I would keep those completely stock when you first start in this game. That's another one of those things. It's just you got to realize that a lot of suspension upgrades and stuff like that, it's only better when you are fast on the bike. You know, it does not help you when you're slower on the bike. A lot of those things. That's why stock suspension is so good for a beginner. And it's kind of one of those things like when you get your suspension set up for a crazy speed, you have to go that crazy speed. If you go medium speed with that setup, it's going to feel like crap. And then you got your setups that feel good at a medium speed, but they feel like crap at a super fast speed. And when I say fast speed, that's all in the eye of the beholder. You know, you can think you're a fast speed just because you beat some people in 03, and then you come on a server with some pros and you get your ass lapped in a hurry. So it's, you know, you've got to stay humble and you've got to realize, okay, I'm at this certain skill level. Let me just upgrade my suspension at my own pace. You know, you've really got to like kind of realize where you're at on the bike. And because there's so many levels to this game, you will think you've got it totally maxed out. You'll think, okay, there's no way I can go faster on the bike. And then you'll go faster. And then you'll put 5 months straight into the game. And then you go even faster than you thought you couldn't go after all that. And then you put another year and a half in the game. And then you're twice as fast as you thought was impossible before that. You know, it's just like an unbelievable, never-ending skill level that I still improve on to this day, and it's just crazy. But like, it gets to a point where you have to upgrade your setup to get more movement on the bike, or you're just not going to be able to move properly enough. But it's one of those things, like with more power is greater responsibility, or whatever the fuck that saying is. You know what I'm saying? Like, the more control you get over the bike, the more movement you can do, it's more responsibility. It's just how the stability is. You know, you cannot hop on there and, as a beginner, and have full movement on the bike. You will never be able to learn the game like that. You just won't, because it's too much movement for your brain to process. This game is totally different than an arcade motocross game. This game, your mind has to slowly build a muscle memory over a long period of time, a super long period of time, and a ton of consistent playing in the game and racing and pushing yourself. And that's the only way to actually improve. And it does not happen overnight. Let me promise you, dude, it takes a long time, but you can't give up on it. You've got to always get a little better, and you change this and update that, and you get a little better here, and you learn this, and then you get better at tripling in, and then you get better and better and better. You get more comfortable racing, and then everything just starts to improve like that. And then before you know it, hey, I could probably ride in a pro race. But just don't ever get over your head with lap times either, because just because somebody can run a fast lap does not mean they can race in a pro race. It's two totally different animals in that sense. Let me assure you, there's a ton of fast lap dudes out there, and they will get lapped in a pro race. It's just that simple. And I just got lapped in last week's pro race. What the fuck am I talking about? But, you know, I would say I'm more of a like consistency kind of guy, and it's just, man, you've got to, the crashing, oh my gosh, it's just unreal how important it is not to crash in this game. It is everything. If I could say the number one most important thing in MX Simulator is don't crash. you could be just chill riding, not even going that fast. And as long as you don't crash, you can be, you know, 3, 4, 5 seconds slower than that person and you will beat them in a race. It is just insane when people have full dismount crashes. And there's kind of a limit. I've started to learn there's kind of a limit to a skill level similar to real life, like, you know, comparing Dungy is sort of, he's kind of the revolutionary maker of that speed level, whereas, like, you know, Roxen kind of goes over that speed level and you see what can happen there. And it's the same thing with MX Simulator. It starts to get this sort of limit there where you're going so fast that it's just uncontrollable, and then you crash and then you lose time. So, you know, there's kind of like a consistency to crash ratio that always sort of keeps its dome. No matter how fast people get or how many people get into the pro racing, there's always that sort of limit there where it's, you're really risking it, you know, you just got to learn that, and over time you get better. But I'll stop ranting. That was the beginner basics guides to MX Simulator. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Anyways, appreciate you guys watching. Later, dudes.